Well, this episode is actually by special request. And not just one person, we've had quite a few people say, hey, what's it look like on the days that you guys have shows? And so we're gonna give you a little behind the scenes tour, and it's pretty much me doing all the work and these two just showing up for the show.
Come on.
Yeah, folks, we've had a lot of requests. Our mom and our dad.
Yep. No. What goes on behind the scenes?
Yeah. Also in today's episode, I know you're gonna be bummed, but we won't be in my kitchen. So we're gonna go down to the real kitchen, the event center, and show you how we make all of the meals before the shows.
So if you come to a show at the Brown Century Theater downtown Lamar's, not only can you stay at our inn, come to a show, you can eat a nice buffet dinner themed for each of the shows that we do throughout the year, a nice buffet meal, and it's right across the street from the theater. You can eat and head over there and hopefully have a good show, and we'll show you what goes into it before you guys get here.
So today's show is a matinee, so the show starts at 1:30, so it's a little different timeline than an evening show. Obviously, we start later in the day. So what does the timeline look like on show days? That's the big question. It starts with me waking up at 6 a.m. and these boys sleeping
Woo,
in.
Woo, way to go, girlfriend.
Oh, that's a nice flex there, Michaela, nice flex.
My day actually starts before because I have to do a lot of the food prep.
I brush
and
my
making
teeth.
Sure we have all of the correct groceries and
hair.
The amounts of food. And so I have to make sure that I go through the list of how many people are coming that weekend. I get all the food, carry it all in, put it all away. And then show day hits. And so I'm usually in the kitchen pretty early in the morning, prepping food, getting it all ready to go. And then mom usually comes in next and she helps get the rest of the dining room set up. And then we have some of our team members come and they finish setting tables. They also help prep food. We get the coffee going, so it smells just wonderful inside.
Wow, that's a really detailed schedule.
Wow, yeah. That is something.
When does
right.
when does the show start?
Speaking of that,
this episode's gonna last 3 hours.
They wanted to know. I'm just telling
well,
them.
Well, now you know. Day. Thank you.
I'm in charge of the food or the kitchen, and so my job is kind of all of the hot food. So I've been in here early morning. And I've got some pork roast, that's for tonight. So I have to have my other pork roast here cooking, barbecue. We got mashed potatoes, sauce for the chicken that's in the oven. And so this is kind of my job, it's all the hot food. And then we also have salads, we have a pasta salad and puff salad, garden salads, and then we have cheesecake for dessert. So this is a little bit of what we're doing, and I have the mashed potatoes done, but I just need to add the finishing touch to make it look beautiful, a little parsley on top. So these are ready to go out into the warmers, and we'll throw those in and get it ready for the buffet. All right, so we'll stick that there, make sure the warmers are on. So this is our hot food buffet, and here's our salad buffet that we'll be bringing out in a little bit. Mom just got the drinks on. She makes the best lemonade.
I try.
And iced tea.
Today we're having cinnamon vanilla.
Cinnamon vanilla.
That's right.
So the year after we bought the theater, we wanted to give people more of an experience. And so we bought this building and we renovated this one. And we wanted to serve people a great meal so they could come and have a dinner and theater experience. Every show has a meal. And what's kind of fun is we're doing our Oh My Iowa show now. So everything is, the menu is themed around Iowa. So obviously corn, and then we have Iowa pork, and then poppy seed chicken, and what else do we have that's Iowa?
Mashed potatoes and gravy.
Oh yeah, mashed potatoes and gravy. So definitely kind of an Iowa theme. Barbecue pork. 4th of July, we did more of a summer theme. The country show will do Salisbury steak, so more of a, you know, down home country meal. At Christmas time, we do a wonderful slow cooked roast beef. We cook it low and slow overnight, so that's phenomenal. And then we, of course, do a chicken dish as well, and do cheesy potatoes, so those are really good. So, always love changing it up.
Thank you.
gravy, made from scratch. That's the bomb right there. See that bubble in there? Now that is good country gravy. So not only do we do musical shows, but we want our guests to have the dinner theater experience. And we've been to so many great places over the years that make wonderful home-cooked food, and we wanted that same experience for the people that come to our theater. So not only do we sing a two-hour show every day, or sometimes two in a day, but we also help cook all the food. Today for our Oh My Iowa shows, we're having good old-fashioned country lemonade and a cinnamon vanilla tea that, well, I kind of came up with the recipe myself. And if you know anything about me and my cooking, I'm a dumper, so it won't taste the same way twice. And don't ask for the recipe because I don't know it. Here's my favorite part of the meal, dessert. Cherry cheesecake, caramel apple cheesecake, a little bit of blueberry cheesecake. So we usually have a dessert bar where you can pick out the dessert that you would like. So we give people a variety. We got extra mashed potatoes, extra chicken and pork in the oven, ready to go out when those pans are empty. So this is about the time I call it quits and head over to the theater.
We serve a three-course meal. We have wonderful salads. We usually have a choice of a fluff salad, a pasta salad, of course, a garden green salad. And then we have our hot dishes. Today, we're having roast pork and dressing, potatoes and gravy, good old Iowa corn. And then, of course, we have our desserts. We usually do a variety of cheesecakes. So, without further ado, I'd like to tell you that the show today will start at 1:30. And you're free to finish your meals. And so we have plenty of time because the show can't start until I get there. Anyway, we hope that you enjoy your day and we hope that you enjoy your meal. So bon appetit.
And Andrew is our go-to guy over there.
Go-to guy? I don't know about that.
He is.
No,
the show
I
would
usually
not go if Andrew was not there.
It kind of depends on when I want to show up. But usually I show up to the theater, walk in the back door, push the coat in, open the door, shut the door, walk in. What does this sound like? It sounds like Michaela.
This is pretty detailed.
No, so I usually show up. Turn the sound on, turn the lights on, get all the sound checked. Yes, pretty much do a sound check before every single show.
A little prepping.
Sometimes we don't do a sound check, but usually always have to, just to make sure everything's working right.
So a lot goes into show days. Downtown Lamar's here, so.
Yeah, a lot goes into show days for Adam. He shows up and sings.
It's show day. It's a nice day, and this is my first T-bomb I've ever had. This is the back door to the theater. VIP access only.
Walk in the back door, walks on stage, and that's
it. But let me explain myself a little more. Every group, no matter what they are, whether they're a country group, a gospel group, a rock group, doesn't matter, every group needs a diva. And I've took it upon myself to show up as late as I can, to get ready as long as I can.
You're not helping yourself.
So we have busted myth number one.
I'm being honest.
Everyone thinks it's me, but it's not.
Yeah, I mean, Mikhail's kind of a diva, but.
Well, if we just took a poll throughout the family who shows up the latest to a show, it would be you.
This is our back little stage, back stairwell. You know, this building used to be a bank, so we turned it into a theater. This
This is the beautiful marble staircase that nobody can see but us. And this is where our offices are, dressing rooms, and whatever else we want. Clothes, storage.
Hey, buddy!
Hey!
Woo!
Cheers.
Come on.
Well,
what I'm watching.
He's watching me.
Here at the Brown Center.
This is where we hang out. We call this our green room. I don't know why they call it green rooms. I think you're supposed to have greens. But we don't have salads or veggies or anything like that.
I don't even think we have water. We have peanuts.
Just this little guy. We got some peanuts and some T-bombs.
What?
Do you know how much caffeine's in these? This thing was huge.
Woo! I don't think I've had enough caffeine.
Ready for the show. How long do we got here? 15 minutes? Long enough for me to take a rest.
16 minutes till the show. And normally, Adam is here
about now.
5 minutes before the show.
Andrew comes before the show. He turns on all the lights, turns all the sound. Takes 5 minutes. And then he comes and sits up here for a while. And then I show up late, and then I get blamed for doing nothing. Which I don't.
It's true. So usually, what do? We sit and talk about our day.
Hey, Mick, get over here.
Mikhail usually tells us some interesting story about what happened this week.
Yes. How was the kitchen?
It was good.
We talk about things that are for sale on Facebook Marketplace.
Scroll on our phones.
Talk a little business. Depends on what's going on. Yesterday, we had a good old business meeting up here at intermission. And we talked about our Florida tour.
Pay raises for everybody!
Wah, wah, wah. We wish. What else did we talk about? We're going on a cruise.
Yep.
A gospel music cruise. And yeah. So we talked a little shop.
I Googled it. In business, the green room is the space in a theater or similar venue that functions as a waiting room and lounge for performers before, during, and after performances or shows and that they are not engaged on stage. Green rooms typically have seating for the performers, such as upholstered chairs and sofas.
That's quite the detail to put in there.
So,
specifically upholstered chairs.
Does it say anything about why?
That's funny.
The origin of the term is often ascribed to such rooms historically being painted green.
Oh.
Modern green rooms need not necessarily adhere to the specifically green color scheme.
Well, you want the upholstered chair specifically, they want it comfortable.
Comfortable.
Because you're going to be hanging out here for after the show.
Folding chair.
Some intermissions for big groups that are about 30 minutes.
Yeah.
So, or you're waiting for the first act to get done and you're hanging out in the green room.
Right.
So, that's what we do in the green room. We talk about green rooms.
Gray rooms.
Or brown rooms.
T-bomb rooms. Brown. We need to paint this brown.
We should.
In our brown room.
Redo.
Hello, Sharon Williams. Can I get some brown paint over here real quick?
Let's go.
T-bomb. Boom. Backstage is huge. Give me a little. Two for the price of one. We don't waste it around here. Hairspray is kind of expensive.
Use every space available. This is actually our motto. It's been our motto ever since we started. Love the people. That takes care of everything.
Check that.
Andrew, we want to build that balcony thing like you were talking with the stairway before Christmas. Before Christmas.
This is all we do. We sit backstage and Andrew hushes us because everybody can hear us.
She talks so loud.
I don't think they can hear us. They're talking and there's music.
I'm serious. Our dad is in the sound booth and he said, I can hear you talking before some shows.
That's
he's all the way at the
true.
Back.
Yes, it is.
It is true.
It's not true.
He probably can hear you right now.
He can't, especially when you're like talking right after.
This is the call. Give dad the call.
Yeah, we're ready. Alright.
It's go time.
It's go time.
Hey.
The Browns Century Theater in Lamar's, the ice cream capital of the world. The Browns share a variety of live music shows throughout the year, showcasing their talents in concert. To start the day, come early for a made-from-scratch Iowa cooking buffet at the beautifully restored Central Event Center. Then save time to shop the fabulous selection of gifts, decor, chocolates, candy, and more. Enjoy a dinner and theater experience at the Browns Century Theater in Lamar's, Iowa.
With 110 cornets, right soon. you all and travel safe.
So we hope you have all enjoyed our behind the scenes, a little taste of what we go through on show days. And of course, after the show, we always like to greet each and every one of you if we can. And that's a nice way to top the day off.
And then we arm wrestle over the leftover popcorn.
Yeah. Yeah, we usually have to take turns. Dad's like, you want some popcorn? I'm like, yeah, tonight's
my
night.
Last week, I got the popcorn. Dad ate it in front of me. And it gave me the last little bit of that. Well,
one night, Dad and I shared the popcorn while I was walking my car. We're just like talking. He's eating it. I'm eating it.
And sometimes there's no popcorn left.
Little side note.
It just depends. But.
No, the popcorn that is left over is the one that I took vacuum up in the theater.
Had a good show. It was pretty close to a full house, which is always great. Had a good afternoon show. It's Saturday afternoon. We sing tomorrow night in Spencer, Iowa. And we gotta shut everything off now. So I get the fun job of turning it on, shutting it off, making sure it all works during the show. So that's it. Lights, all the fun stuff. Thanks for hanging out with us today, behind the scenes at the theater. See you next time. Passing it on.
Well, we hope you enjoyed Hometown with the Browns. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, comment, like the video, and share it. You can see more of the Browns every week.